There's this ideology, أخي, amongst the Muslim Ummah that أهل القرآن are those who recite, memorize the Quran. لا يا أخي, أهل القرآن are those who first and foremost understand the Quran. Number two, act
Act
upon it.
out.
And then if they know how to recite it, alhamdulillah. If they've memorized it, وإلا were all of the companions, حفاظ القرآن,
No.
are all of the companions from أهل القرآن, yes or no?
Yes.
Wallahi they are. Listen to this ayah, because wallahi it's been misquoted so many times. Allah says in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Almost everyone misunderstands it. Those who is given the book to, يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. This word يَتْلُونَ, تَلَا يَتْلُو, تِلَاوَةً, yes, it can mean recitation, but that's not the only meaning linguistically. تَلَا يَتْلُو means to follow. That's why وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا. So if you go back to the tafsir of the Salaf, Ibn Abbas and the likes, they say يَتَّبِعُونَهُ حَقَّ اتِّبَاعِهِ. لا إله إلا الله. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ يَتَّبِعُونَهُ. They follow it the way it should be followed. That's the tafsir of the ayah. But how do they translate it? Most of the translations say they recite it the way it should be recited.
SubhanAllah.
لا يا أخي. أولئك يؤمنون به. يعني your iman in the Quran is measured by how good you recite it. When in essence, the measure you should have for Ahlul Quran is their understanding of the Quran and the way they act upon it and how they follow it. And the first thing you have to follow when it comes to the Quran is Tawheed and Sunnah. So in other words, those who are upon Tawheed and Sunnah, living according to it, upon the way of the Salaf, they are the most deserving of
Ahlul
Ahlul
Quran.
Quran. Than anybody else. If there's anyone's Ahlul Quran, they are Ahlul Quran.